Time now for the RidicuList, and tonight we have what I believe is the first ever RidicuList three-peat. And who better to make RidicuList history than our friend William Tapley, better known as...
the third eagle of the apocalypse and the co-prophet of the end times.
How do you get to be the co-prophet of the end times? I mean, is it such a sought-after position that they had to divide it up? Anyway, as any fan of the Third Eagle's YouTube videos knows, he is, for some inexplicable reason, kind of obsessed with hidden phalluses, which he sees all over the Denver International Airport.
They are evil. They are signs of Satanism. And on this program, I will point out that many of them are phallic symbols.
Clearly.
Just mean, he sees a box on the penguin.
Mr. Leo,
that's the box on the penguin as a prominent penguin penis. He's even highlighted it for your enjoyment. This is on a painting apparently at the Denver International Airport. Now, I put him on the RidicuList a while back. He responded, put him on again, and now, like mana from heaven, and if you by mana mean man parts, he's responded again.
I guess you could call this the rubber match. Well, maybe that's not quite the correct term.
Saucy. Who knew the co-prophet of the end times would have such a naughty sense of humor? I'm starting to see how he got to be the co-prophet after all. Although I think his presentation was a little stiff and perhaps premature.
I honestly believe that Mr. Cooper is beginning to agree with me.
Not so fast, Third Eagle. Do you mind if I call you Third Eagle? I try to keep an open mind, but you lose me when you claim there is a horse at the airport covered in phalluses. In order to prove it, I would need a closer look.
Let's take a closer look at the mane on this blue demon horse. Now, these sure look like phallic symbols to me. I don't know. What do you think, Mr. Cooper? Maybe you think they're ice cream cones.
Note to self, don't ever go to Baskin Robbins with the Third Eagle of the Apocalypse. Between the cones, the banana splits, the cherries, not to mention the nuts, an ice cream parlor is Satan's snack bar. Now, longtime followers of the co-prophet will no doubt already know that it's not just the penguin and the horse that are the problem, but it is the Denver International Airport's entire outdoor baggage handling area.
The outdoor baggage handling area is in the shape of a phallus. Let's take a closer look.
And that is exactly what he does in his new video. In fact, Mr. Tapley has taken his phallus philosophy, or philosophy, into a whole new level. It's not just the phallus-shaped terminal and the low-hanging baggage area that now concerns him. It's also salacious surrounding street names.
Mural. What do you suppose this street name is that runs right down the center? You guessed it. That's Pena Boulevard.
Sorry. All right, actually, I did not guess that. I was hoping for Urethra Boulevard. Pena is named for Federico Pena, the former mayor of Denver. But anyway, that's just one street. It's not like there's others.
I guess you could call this the pubic hair area. So what do you suppose the name of this street is right here? This is the Harry B. Combs Parkway.
Harry B. Combs was an aviator and a writer. Who cares? Matter.
This street right here, this is Shady Grove Street. I guess that's because that's where the sun don't shine.
The sun don't... I think he's getting his anatomical references confused now.
If they ever cut the flow of traffic on this little street leading down to Pena Boulevard, I bet they will call that a vasectomy.
That is just a fallacy. Anyway, say what you will about the co-prophet. He cares about people almost as much as he cares about fallacies.
As for you, Mr. Cooper, do you want to be remembered as the most naive reporter in the history of television?
Well, no, I wanted to be remembered as Third Eagle of the Apocalypse, but that name was already taken.
And, Mr. Cooper, I am going to send you a copy of my free book. I hope this address is correct.
I got the book. Thank you kindly. That was a very nice gesture. So, you know what? Let's just end this whole war of words. I am officially extending the olive branch. Oh, no. He's not going to like that, is he? We've got to work on that. Please don't get too testy. William Tapley, it has indeed been a long and winding road. Thank you for the memories, and you are hereby, from now until the end times, first eagle of the RidicuList.